Hanukkah vacation? What vacation? So I was off school for Hanukkah last week. It was nice. I had a lot of family here from Toronto, and uncle, cousins, cousin-in-law, cousin's kid. I was able to spend a little bit of time with all of them, so that was really nice. One of my cousins, as I mentioned in my last video, stayed in my apartment for most of her vacation here. So, which was great, so she kept me company because all my dear roommates went home for Hanukkah. Honestly, it really was not much of a vacation. Basically, a few days after Hanukkah break, we had an exam, a major exam, on nephrology, endocrinology, gastroenterology, neurology, and infectious diseases. This exam is for a course called Internal Adult Nursing, and it's a 12-credit course, which is a huge, huge part of our degree, basically. And it's split into three huge exams, and the first one of which was this week. You have to pass each of these exams separately in order to continue on with your studies. It's scary because there are about 10 girls who failed last year and are now in my class this year, doing it again. So if you don't pass any of these exams, you have to stay back a year and take the course over again. So there are about 10 girls who failed last year, and it's really scary because most of these girls are single girls. Not that they're married or they have kids or have any obligation aside from studying. So that's what I did all of Hanukkah. I studied. A few Shabbos ago, I was in Tirat Tzvi, which is a kibbutz near Beit She'an in the north. I went there for a friend's Shabbat Kalah. The name of the kibbutz, Tirat Tzvi, might sound familiar to you for a few reasons. First of all, it was the first religious kibbutz in Israel. Second, they're very well known for their date palms. Third, for their meat. And fourth, Gion Yuris' Exodus. On Shabbos, we were given a tour of the kibbutz. It was really, really interesting because a lot of things within the kibbutz are still the same from what they were years ago back when it functioned completely like a kibbutz. Like, for example, they have a laundry building and everyone does their laundry together. Everybody's clothes are labeled with their own personal number and they just put their own laundry in all the compartments depending on how they want to wash. You know, cold water, hot water, gentle, cottons, wools, like anything. And it was really interesting and I really wish I could have used my camera. After Shabbos, I took advantage of the fact that I was in Tirat Tzvi to visit the meat factory outlet. I've wanted to make meatballs for a while now, but cow is really expensive in Israel. But at the factory outlet store of Tirat Tzvi, I got 2 kilo of ground beef for just 50 shekel, which is around $15, half the price of what you get in a regular supermarket in Israel. So all in all, it was quite a successful trip to Tirat Tzvi. And this girl whose Shabbos Kalah it was, the wedding was this past week, also a really, really lovely, fun, nice, overall just nice wedding. Well, the band was very good and it was very interesting to see a Hasidish man playing an electric guitar and singing secular music. And then near the end, there was this old couple just like dancing together and it was like really cute. Mixed dancing.
Hayom yom huledet, hayom yom huledet, hayom yom huledet, le shira, hayom.